I'd like to give him a big round of applause as he finds his way to the blue corner. Please welcome William Mel. Come on, put your hands together for William. Come on, Rudy Hill. And the opposition finding his way to the red corner, Stefan De Silva! De Silva!
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity, seize everything you ever wanted.
Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, doing a service, he looks calm and ready to drop arms, but he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking now, everybody's choking now, the clock's run out, time's up, over, loud, stand back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes gravity. Choke, he's so mad, but he won't give up.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The contest is scheduled for 10 three-minute rounds for the WBL Junior Lightweight title of the world. I'll take you to the blue corner first. Tonight he comes in scaling 50, arrives in Australia with one victory and one draw from six professional bouts, hailing from Fiji Suva, William Mel! And the opposition in the red corner. Tonight he comes in at 57.95 kilograms, wearing the black, jet black boxing trunks. One professional bout, one victory. His first contest in Australia tonight. Give him a big welcome from Georgetown, Guyana. Here he is, Stefan De Silva. De Silva. When the bell rings and the action begins, your third man as the referee is William Sulos.
Right, gentlemen, we've got a title fight here. I'm assuming you both know the rules. You will listen to my instructions. You will obey.
It's time for another title fight. I'm Tony Slerner. We've got a treat. I'm joined by Clive Elwell, the former WBC Junior Lightweight Champion from the Caribbean. Great to have your company this evening.
Here, unlike the very promoted Gary Sinclair, there was the Victor Graffit, there is the Vivian Harris, and the first one of them all, Andrew Sixel, you know.
Plenty of great fighters to come out of Guyana for sure. And of course, congratulations to Gary Sinclair as well, being named in the Australian National Boxing Hall of Fame as well in August. That was a fantastic achievement.
Oh yes, not only for Gary but the entire Guyana. And to mention, he is the only athlete from Guyana that would have been crowned in an International Hall of Fame. And so that is something big. And back to the fight, as we see the William Mel with a sweeping left hook, almost connected the jaw of the silver.
Yeah, William Mel. Both orthodox fighters trying to pick their spots, trying to find a way through. Happy to lock up, just slow things down a little bit. It's been a very high octane first round.
And that's what happens when you come out winging. You know, it takes away the energy early if your opponent doesn't drop. You know, but the silver got to be careful, though. He is stepping in with his head down. And if Mel were to play strategically, pull himself back and shoot an uppercut, the silver can find himself in trouble.
We'll take
if Stefan is to play his card right, he could well be in line to become the next world champion, as he has to experience as stalwarts in his corner. Mark Hardman of Boxing Burn, the boxing fanatic of Australia. I know him personally. When I fought here in 2014, he was the man that led me to Kai McKenzie. And I see there he has Johnny Lewis as his partner.
Oh, big connection from both fighters. De Silva rocked William Mel. Mel trying to hook up, slow things down and get separated. What a start to round two. Tony Salerno and Clive Orwell, your commentators. And now the referee just having a quick word to William Mel. Just making sure. Can't hit at the back of the head.
Can't hit at the back of the head.
That's right.
But as we can see, Tony, that so far both fighters seems to want it, you know. At the end of the day, it comes down to who wanted the more.
Both fighters backing their power as well. Both look quite strong. The reach, both fighters are around the same height, but maybe just a little bit of an advantage to Stefan De Silva, I'd say.
Yeah. Beautiful job from the opponent in the blue, as he picked the silver coming in with his head down.
Yeah, William Mel from Fiji, another beautiful part of the world.
Yes, I hope to be able to visit there someday. Who knows, could very well be for boxing if William Mel is to pull off a miracle tonight. You never know.
Yeah, that's right. Very even fight, this one. One of the really hyped up fights on this card.
Yes.
One of the very, very exciting fights. I know when I saw this fight on the card, I was very excited to be commentating it. See Stephen De Silva.
For right hand to the chest of De Silva. The Silva seems to be
Silva
the one
now working the body.
Yes.
Trying to soften up with body shots, hoping that he can
break
the
movements of William Mel.
And trying to get him to break down his guard and then come over the top and get him with a sweet shot. So, a bit of strategy from De Silva. Just say the first two rounds, Clive, maybe De Silva on top a little bit.
Yes, definitely. He has the reach. He would have.
So, a bit of strategy from De Silva. Just say the first two rounds, Clive, maybe De Silva on top a little bit.
Yes, definitely. He has the reach. He would have been able to land it more effective punch, in my opinion. But now this round, we have Mel. Oh, beautiful right hand.
Oh, combination from De Silva. Stayed up, William Mel. That one won't count as a knockdown.
No, he was still on his feet. De Silva's more built. He seems to be more calm now. He's picking his punches now. I want to believe that William Mel is hurt. I want to believe he's hurt. That right hand would have tagged him and he's grabbing the body.
What do those shots do, Clive, to the kidney? They just so powerful. Starts making you, it makes you struggle to breathe. You're trying to get as much oxygen in. Can't do that. You get fatigued. Then you're in trouble.
Oh, and he has him in the corner. Mel seems to be tagged and he's grabbing again for a break. I believe Stefan would have tagged him there and a shuffle at the end.
I think William Mel's very happy to hear the ring bell for the end of the second round. We'll join you in a matter of moments for the third round action.
Yeah.
Yep, ready and back for round three. Stephen De Silva taking on William Mel of Fiji. I've got Clive Orwell, WBC junior lightweight, welterweight.
And
Caribbean
it is over.
Fighter.
It is over.
It's done already.
Referee stopped the contest. William Mel has been cut over his right eye. And the referee stopped the contest. De Silva seems to be upset because he don't believe he were able to display himself. No, they're greeting each other's sportsmanship. And like you mentioned, what a fight. It is over.
Yeah, is already. Over. So only didn't get started in the third round. Tell you what, Clive, both fighters going really hard really early, and that's just what can happen.
Yes.
William got some bruising in the body and then ultimately a cut, which meant he couldn't continue. So our winner, Stephen De Silva, but it was short and sweet, Clive.
Short
it was
and
great
sweet.
To have you on commentary tonight.
Yes, it definitely was a pleasure to be here. You know, and now Guyana is crowned with a new world champion, the WBL lightweight world champion, Stephen De Silva, after fight having come to naught.
Thank you
for having me.
Very much so, Clive. Always a pleasure to have you. So there you have it, Stephen De Silva, the WBL junior lightweight world champion, after defeating William Mill in just over two rounds. We're going to bring Dave McDonald back in. It was only a short break for the both of us. One of the big 10-round fights anticipated over rather quickly in two rounds.
It's an anti-climax, but both fighters really came pressing each other. It was a good start to watch. That's boxing, isn't it, unfortunately? The doctor has made the call. Cannot overrule the doctor.
Oh, of course. Safety first. Of course, that's what we do here in Gary St. Clair fight night. We had Clive Orwell, a really astute boxing mind. Great to have him on commentary this evening. Gary St. Clair just marshalling troops, ready to give out another title that is going to go to Stephen De Silva. We're going to throw it down to Stephen in a matter of moments to receive his belts and get the official decision.
Well, your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Upon the retirement of the blue corner, William Mel, the new WBL junior lightweight world champion from the red corner, from Georgetown, Guyana, Stephen De Silva. De Silva. And Gary St. Clair putting the belt around the champion's waist, former two-time IBF and IBO world champion. Gary, what a great little fighter.
Well, man, listen, this kid is everything. This kid just come to Australia. He's just been boxing for a bit, you know what I mean? And look at him now, he's champ of the world. Came all the way from Guyana with nothing. Dreams come true, guys. And my friends in Guyana, you're watching this. This is living example. Dream come true. This kid come from nothing. Just like Gary Sinclair, now he's champ of the world. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, man, guys. Thanks for coming out. Thank you very much. Chris, my man, please enjoy this moment. This is your moment. Say something nice to my people in Guyana.
Good.
My people in Guyana.
Good luck to you, my friend. And that's some nice words from Gary. So look at your record now. Two professional bouts for two victories and you've already won a minor world title.
Yes, I am. I'm very happy about it. First, I want to thank God for this victory. I want to thank everybody back home who have supported me, especially my family, you know, they ran it from day one for me. My little daughter, my son, happy birthday to you, Brian. That's why I know that I love you, and soon I'll be home. See you soon, Guyana, as we celebrate one Guyana, the WBL World Champion!
Yeah, man, we got it in the house, bro. Gary Sinclair, man, thank you very much, Guyana. We love you. We will be back there. One Guyana, one Guyana, one Guyana.
All right, from one champion to another, little Gary there putting in his bed. I look in the corner there, I see Johnny Lewis. They've got a lot of... experience behind you with Gary and Johnny and Peter and everybody, so you're a lucky man to have someone with his craft in your corner.
You know, it's very nice to meet my guy Johnny. You know, since the day I entered the country, he was there for me. And thank you very much, Johnny. We get the next one soon again.
Okay, Stefan, the next one soon again. So when will that be? Here we are in September. We've still got 3 or 4 months to go. We'll see you back shortly.
Well, whenever they need me, I'm here.
Okay, well, there he is, the new champion, WBL Junior Lightweight World Champion, Stefan De Silva.